So it's been a year since BB called on the International Atomic Energy Agency to inspect what he was calling a secret atomic warehouse in Tehran. And he was saying that they were housing over 15 kilos of radioactive materials at the site, which is a crazy amount. And now it looks like he was right. According to two unnamed diplomats, samples were taken back in April that did reveal traces of uranium, and Iran still hasn't given an explanation for this. The diplomats are saying that there could be multiple reasons for having these traces of uranium, but because of the lack of response from Iran, the IAEA can't verify the uranium's origins. But what we do seem to know now is that they have been hiding nuclear sites from the international community. And this is also happening after Iran has, for the third time, broken the JCPO agreement. Saturday, they did confirm that they were injecting uranium into centrifuges that are banned under the deal. And they've increased the stockpile of uranium to much more than what was agreed on back in July.
Okay, so this one was a contentious one. It turns out cameras will not be allowed in polling sites after all, despite the fact that the cabinet unanimously passed draft legislation yesterday supporting it. Israel Beitenu leader Avigdor Lieberman was the last holdout needed to keep this bill from moving forward. The Central Elections Committee and Attorney General Mandelblit both tried to keep the bill from passing. They said it could have intimidated voters and even been unconstitutional. Mandelblit thought a hasty rollout of the plan could have led to total chaos on election day. Lieberman says he would only go for it under the appropriate oversight. Prime Minister Netanyahu hoped the bill would eliminate voter fraud. The election comes in 8 days.
Hey, happy birthday to Israel's current president, Reuven Rivlin, who some call Ruvi and is turning 80 today. Ruvi has been in politics since 1988 and has previously served as the Minister of Communications and Speaker of the Knesset. He's said to be quite a charmer, adores kids, and was apparently a romantic when it comes to his late wife, Naama. Ruvi speaks fluent Arabic, and his dad was the first one to create a Hebrew edition of the Quran. So, if you're going out for a drink tonight, make sure to toast one to Ruvi. Happy birthday.